Hello and welcome to Unit 5. This unit is on empirical power law distributions. The central question we'll consider is as follows. Suppose you're studying some phenomenon and you have a set of data. How can you figure out if that data is well described by a power law? And if so, what's the best way to estimate the power law exponent? It turns out that these questions can be surprisingly subtle, and it's easy to approach them in the wrong way. I'll begin in the next subunit by looking at different ways of representing data. So we'll talk about histograms, but then also cumulative distribution functions and rank frequency plots. I'll then give a brief survey of some of the phenomena that are thought to be distributed according to power laws. And then we'll start looking at some of these questions of inference. Given that we suspect that something's a power law, what's the best way to estimate the parameters that describe the distribution? We'll also need to talk about alternatives. By that I mean there may be other distributions that describe your data better than a power law. And there's some distributions that are often confused with power laws, in particular stretched exponentials and log normals. So what I'll do is I'll say a little bit about those other distributions, talk about how, compare and contrast them to power laws, and then talk about some statistical techniques for choosing among those different options. Before we get started, another word or two about this unit. I will frequently be referring to a couple of really key papers in empirical power laws and inference with power laws, and I've put a list of those papers along with links to PDFs in a subunit or a section called, I think, Additional Resources. So you can find all the papers that I'm going to mention right there. So they should, you shouldn't have to look around for them. Additionally, I'm going to be mentioning a bunch of statistical techniques. And we're not going to get so involved that I'm going to show you step by step how to do them. I think that's too much statistics and beyond the scope of this course. But I suspect and I hope that some of you will want to try these things out on your own. So there's some good software that's out there that's been developed in the last 5 years or so. And links to those software are also in this additional resources section. There's some Python code, some R code, and a little bit of MATLAB code as well. So if you want to actually try some of this stuff out, those should be some pretty good places to start. Okay, so let's begin by thinking about power law distributions by looking at how to represent data. And I'll do so with a simple example that will lead us through the construction of a cumulative distribution function and a rank frequency plot. You'll see it's easier to calculate than it is to say. So let's get started.